Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
I also want to give a shout out to Music Connection Magazine. I'm going to be in it, I know it, because I'm going to be singing a Johnny Cash song, Ghosts of Prison.
It's rolling around a bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on.
Are you a Mexican or a Mexican?
I'm a Mexican.
When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy.
My good friend Coyote, Freddy the Granny, he asked me if I'd host this event for him, and you know, he's got a standing yes. You know what I mean? So me and Freddy did Blood In, Blood Out in San Quentin in 1991, I think, and yeah, he's been a good friend ever since. He said, we're doing this event, and I go, yeah, let's do it, man. And so tonight I get to sing with the Walking Phoenix. I'm singing Folsom Prison.
Is that going to be the Johnny Cash song?
Yeah. They're a Johnny Cash tribute band.
Oh, yeah, really.
I have Fuego's Tacos opening up pretty soon, you know, and that's probably the end of September, the beginning of October. And it's on La Brea between Pico and Olympia. And we're going to feature some pretty healthy food. And then we just finished the Adam Sandler movie, The Ridiculous Six.
How's that? When's that coming out?
Probably the end of the year. It's a funny movie.
Nice. I actually drove by Trail Tacos the other night, and I was surprised when I saw it, because I didn't realize it was so close to my house, you know?
Yeah, it's right there, man.
Is there going to be
a good job.
Is there going to be a second location?
Yeah, the next location, I think we're going to do on Cahuenga between Hollywood and Sunset. It's a great location right there by Selma. Friday, Saturday night, that place is wide open, so it's going to be a lot of fun. Freddy the Greatest, he's taking me up a pattern, you know, right now. Mark Mahoney did the one on my back, so I gotta get something from Freddy.
Can you show me a quick, your chest piece, the OG chest piece right there?
That's the most famous tattoo in the world. Yeah, that was a India ink and needle.
What age were you when you got that one?
That was 19, I started that. In 1965, in San Quentin, and from a tattoo artist named Harry Super Jew Ross, and he passed away already, but we still in Quentin, and I got kicked out of Quentin, I got sent to Folsom. He told me, wait, don't let nobody do the first tattoo he did, you know, so he wanted to finish it, so he came to Folsom about 6 months later. And then there was a riot in Folsom. I got sent to Solitaire, and he wanted to finish it. He was almost done. So about a year later, he showed up in Solitaire, and that's when we finished it. And he didn't like it because it was his first tattoo, you know, and he became a really good tattoo artist. So he hated it, but it made him famous. Because if you look at the lines are pretty thick, you know what I mean? But it was boom, 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 needle and thread. And you know, they don't allow tattoos in the joint. And we were in the three major joints, so it was pretty dangerous. But we finished it. This one was done by Rudy Machine. And I think he passed away too. That was done in Solidarity. Yeah. You know, we just... His tattoo, the one on my back, that was my kids. That's actually out here on the streets, and that was done by Mark.
Can you see that one? Nice.
That's Mark Mahoney. So now Freddy's getting me up a piece. I'm trying to figure out what to do. When me and Freddy were doing Blood In, Blood Out, we were in San Quentin, and he was already really famous as Coyote in in the tattoo genre. So all the guys that were doing tattoos in the joint were bringing in these old messed up guns that they made, right? And Freddie was, no, wait. He'd like fix them. I said, Freddie, you know, you'd fit right in here. And so I always tease him about, hey, you made any tattoo guns lately? Because, I mean, literally, these guys worshiped him because he put all their guns together so they would work by line and in their minds. I've always complimented him. Freddie! We're doing awesome on that. It's the second season, and I think that's going to go. They're going to be picking that up. It's a great, great series, and I don't... I play the regulator, you know, I don't negotiate, I regulate.
any news on any upcoming new Predator movie? The last one you were in, that was dope.
Well, I think we're going to do Machete Kills in space. And everybody says, why space? I said, shit, James Bond went into space.
Yeah, you'd be the first Mexican in space. That's it. When is that one going to be a production on that?
We're going to start that around December.
Nice.
Me and Robert, yeah, we'll figure out, start shooting.
That's good.
First of all, everybody, I do for inviting me, and especially want to thank Freddie, and we need more things like this to just keep bringing people together. You know, that's what we got to do. We're all on this planet together, you know, so the more events that we can pull people together, the better. You know, Lincoln Park, especially Lincoln Park is a real famous park back in the 60s, you know, so I'm glad we're still here, you know, and still, you know, moving forward. I also want to give a shout out to Espada Herrera.